Simon, your mustache looks a little disheveled today. What's
going
on?
I've gone natural, mate. We are recording a little bit early.
It's a Sunday, isn't it? Jeez. I almost blacked out and felt it was Monday. I was like, this is Sunday. This is not.
We are recording a day earlier than usual. And I'll be honest, I had a bit of a natural Sunday. I didn't want to put any wax in my mustache today. So.
Oh. All natural, all Sunday.
All natural. So I'm like an otter today.
I'm an otter? What?
Well, we got a new name.
I just feel like I look like a furry animal rather than...
Of all the furry animals, you went for an otter. Interesting.
Otters are cute as, mate.
What do you think that says about you?
Yeah. Stinky. But yeah, anyway.
Stinky.
I could have gone walrus, but it's not quite as droopy as a walrus.
Well, we're doing
or
this...
like a King Charles Spaniel.
Anyway.
I think you got it, yeah.
We're doing this. We're doing this.
That or my wax.
Why are we doing this, Hamish? Hamish, why are we recording on?
My wax hasn't come in yet. So,
why are we recording on a Sunday?
We're doing it a day early because tomorrow I'm at a wedding. Another Monday wedding.
Mate, I tell you what, they're so expensive. You might as well just get married when it's cheapest.
Yeah, but it's a pain in the butt for my wife Faye because she works in the school, so she doesn't get annual leave, so she has to work a day in the summer holidays to get these days off. So, but we've got hotels. Oh, yes. So it'll be the first time me and Faye are away from the kids in a hotel.
Say no more.
Yeah. It'll be. I'm looking forward to it. But it's more importantly, it's actually disturbed the Push the Point bi-weekly meetup, which was, you know,
it has,
which has just infuriated me. But this time, instead of doing it on a Wednesday and me making a mad dash rush to get this edited, we're going to do it on a Sunday where it probably still won't make any difference.
You're still going to edit it on a Wednesday because you're at a wedding.
No, he's going to use that extra day for full effect, I can tell. You're going to get it done nice and early on a Tuesday, maybe.
No.
I'm going to have loads of time to work on the thumbnail. It's going to be fantastic.
I can guarantee you'll be doing the thumbnail on the Friday.
Half an hour before it goes live, baby. Yeah. Every time.
Welcome to the inner workings.
We had to release a video without one of my thumbnails for the first time. I think
in a long time
ever. Have we ever done a video?
I think we've used a placeholder before.
No, yeah. Sean did it with his own videos when he did the stream stuff.
Oh.
Right?
I think the streams. I did the thumbnail for the streams.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. As well,
how do you feel about that trip?
I don't care. I was on holiday. I was like, great, Sean's doing.
I actually did look at it, and I was like, you know what? It could have been you.
No, it's far too much effort in for one of mine. I was gonna say, Sean actually got cards and stuff. He probably even watched the video. Can't remember the last time I watched the video.
He did. I was looking at this going.
He is a brute player, man.
This is pretty good, actually. You did a good job. Good. Well done, Sean.
I just want to say thanks to Sean because this is going very much into home news territory. I'm taking a very direct.
Why don't we do direct route?
Do you want to do the beers first and then?
I was thinking you do the wheel and then we'll do the beers and then we do.
No. I am not waiting that long for beers.
Beers, wheel, home news.
Let's do it.
Hamish, what are you drinking today?
Well, I went over to the shop to get a Brew Gooder in collaboration with Brooklyn Beer, the Funio Session IPA.
Well,
it does look good.
Yeah. It's a Brooklyn brewery.
It's a collab.
It's a collab, yeah. So it's brewed on purpose.
Brew Gooder, the Edinburgh Brew Gooder people.
Yeah.
That's pretty cool.
They're nice. What about you, what did you say, Otter Boy?
Otter boy.
Wow.
Otter man, not a real big man.
Oh, I like it.
That's good.
From my usual, because I'm running out. So I've gone for an Aldi specially selected coffee stout.
I've had a couple of those. They are very, very tasty.
Coffee flavor beer. Yeah,
it's really coffee flavored to the point where if you have one before bed, you kind of feel like you're going to be up all night. That's all I'm saying.
Wow.
Shout out to my parents who shop in Aldi and always have a few of those when I go home.
I mean, Aldi's spot on.
Good beer. Good beer, what can I say?
What about you? Okay, so stick on trip.
Oh, did we have any entries to that competition?
Yeah, we did. Some people got three or four.
Well, no, the most.
What do they have to get?
Five.
Five.
Yeah.
Jeez.
I'll tell you what, actually, I thought, no, this is easy. And to the people who tried and the people who didn't know, I'm going to give you some, right? And it was really easy. I thought, well, if you think Orlando Bloom.
It's really easy.
Yeah, that's yeah. one. So there's, that's the so, OG.
So Orlando Bloom, followed by Legolas, mm-hmm. followed by Troy. Yep.
Oh,
yeah,
Troy.
That was a brief one.
Troy
Very
was good.
Brief.
And we have James White's son.
James White's
yeah,
son.
A yeah, a classic. Come on, guys.
Louis Theroux.
Yeah.
Oh,
yes.
Of course.
Louis Theroux is off podcast as well. That's a common one.
The wild card.
Yeah.
Stick on Trip.
Stick on Trip.
I mean, that's okay, guys. That's seven.
Yeah, seven.
There you go. Yeah, you need five.
Orlando Bloom are basically the same
Anything
one.
Anything Orlando Bloom, yeah.
Orlando, oh, Troy was the real one. Anyway.
Troy was really obscure. So if you got Troy, well done.
Okay.
But you didn't. I'm almost scared. I didn't read the comments. I know you didn't.
We haven't gone with Pirates of the Caribbean or Orlando Bloom yet, have we?
No, I don't think.
No, he didn't look like. Troy really
Which
didn't
Which is
look
weird
like,
because, because Legolas looks nothing like me.
No,
he's
this is true. He is blonde. Yeah,
okay.
I probably look more like the guy from. Anyway, sorry.
Wild card or stick on trip? I do. I think stick on trip is the real. Like that's a real sticker. What about you? What are you drinking?
Well, I went down to my shop and I just got a big Corona.
Oh,
it's a very big one.
It is a very big 620 one.
620 mil.
That's what she said.
Not for any particular. Yeah, she said it was 620 milliliters long. That's what I got. So.
Have you got a lime?
That is the scoring. This is really middle aged.
Actually, Kate, can you get me the lime?
Oh, look at that!
We don't actually have any lime.
Do you?
You could cut the glass of that bottle and sand down the top.
We only have lime cordial.
Make it a glass.
That's Kate's hand, by the way, in case anyone's watching.
Hi, I just saw this.
There we go.
That's my favourite bit.
Oh, she's brought back the lid, but she wasn't on camera.
I like that he's putting lime cordial in it.
Well, I don't have any lime. We don't have any lime.
Can
so
I ask you a
lime
question?
Lime cordial would do the trick. Of course you can, Hamish.
Lime.
So, Trip, we already know the answer. If you do you request stuff from Kate? So, for example, do you ask Kate, can you get me a drink?
If she's going to the kitchen, I'll ask, can you make me a cup of tea? Or if she's going to boil the kettle, I'll ask that.
Okay.
But she'll ask me if I'm doing the same.
Okay, yeah.
So I did ask her to bring me my baseball cap right before the podcast started, but that's because I'm very much locked in. There's a lot of cables that surround me when I'm recording Push the Point, plugged in very different ways, so I can't really move.
Okay.
Much.
Simon? Do you ask Nikki? Nikki, can you get me a drink? Can you get me some?
It's usually the other way around. We'll usually offer, like, if we're going to the kitchen, like, do you want a cup of tea or do you want a drink?
Okay, cool.
I'm just
curious, and I can imagine. I think Faye's floating around.
Is it a dressing gown kind of night?
Well, it's always a dressing gown kind of night. That's why they call me Hamish Dressing Gown. Get it? It's Hamish Chisholm Brown Dressing Gown.
Oh God.
I thought that was deeper than nothing.
I didn't realize it was actually.
They used to call me in school the dressing gown, and I used to
Hamish dressing gown.
Yeah,
Hamish Brown.
Yeah,
it's really. That's
clever. It's good. Anyway,
it's clever. Yeah.
It's good. You like it? Well, actually, did we did
it doesn't
actually
work if you call it a house coat.
I know. I was about to make a point, but now you sidetracked me. We actually did go out in town. And you had to in a dressing gown. Yeah, it was like my 20 something. It was like a birthday, so we're gonna go out in gown. So we all went out in town dressed in a gown. Anyway, so
nice.
I would if I asked Faye, can you get me a drink? She would tell me to go
swivel.
Yeah, 100%. Like if I said, oh, can you get me a drink? She'd be like, no, get one yourself. But if I go to the kitchen. Can you top up my water? And me being a little
stand-up gent.
Stand-up gent, that's it. That's the podcast term. I do. So I was just curious.
That's the monetization term.
So I'm just curious, chat.
You feel a little bit hard done by, is that
no,
what
I'm just sort of sitting there thinking, the chat.
Is there an inequity in your drink?
I'm just curious.
Did you just refer to our audience as chat?
Yeah, I did.
No, chat.
You're such a millennial.
Oh, did I?
Oh, you're not even a millennial. That's like Zoomer talk right there.
Right,
chat.
Chat. Well, I'm probably thinking we're streaming. I'm just curious.
Push the point, audience. What do you think about being referred to as chat by Hamish? I'm interested.
Okay.
I thought he just called him chat.
Names. Oh, chaps. Yeah, that would work. What are we doing? Wheel of names. Do you want to do that? Should we keep it going?
Yeah, let's keep it going. Okay, true. Yeah, I was good. My hands are ready for
the
home news.
When we have to record on Sunday.
It's a momentous occasion.
Oh my
God! I don't think this person is one. I'm sure. I'm having doubts.
Is it Jake?
It is Jake. Hey.
Jake Arms.
And I'm like, Jake has another one.
No, Shin has one, but Jake has.
Everybody. Else, apart from all the people that haven't won, finally Jake
is an OG.
Jake
He's
Arms.
Like a first patron. He did it.
He was very early on. We know him well.
And he's going to get his favorite set.
Famously, Jake, judge of Flesh and Blood, even when he's playing. And we love him a lot. And look forward to receiving your packs in the post from Sean very soon.
Looking forward to playing against Jake in the Nationals. That's all I'm saying.
You always play Jake in Nationals. Is that what happens?
No, I'm just being horrible because we're all reminding Jake that he didn't make Nationals. Okay, so what?
Jake's a bit harsh.
That completely passed me by.
Can you imagine? Just you're having a nice, relaxing evening, listening to your favourite podcast, Push the Point, and then they just start chatting shit about you.
We gotta be careful. He might sue us.
Just like catching strays.
You've won.
The podcast. For the ages of legalese to arrive on our desk tomorrow morning.
Financially supported for probably over a year. Just like,
I think it's about 2 years now. Jake's been a patron. Yeah.
Okay, so tell us tell us a bit more about the Wheel of Time.
So, if you are a patron of Push the Point, and again we've had a couple of newbies very recently, so since the last episode, so thank you very much to our new members. You have a chance of winning 6 packs of Flesh and Blood. At the moment it is Bright Lights. I think when that runs out we may have some new products.
We've got
wild card product to come as well, so we're going to mix it up once we're out of Bright Lights. And all you have to do is be a patron. You can join and support anywhere from like £3 to £10 a month is the bracket. You just get entered into a giveaway every episode, so that's twice a month. So if you just win once, you basically get your yearly membership of Push the Point paid for in one go, and there's 24 ish giveaways a year, so it's pretty good odds. But that's not the only thing you get for being a Push the Point patron, isn't it, Hamish?
No, Trip. You also get 10% off of Thistle Tavern, a Scottish shingle seller from the UK. He sells lots of variety of different cards from Lorcana, One Piece, as well as, of course, Flesh and Blood and Star Wars Unlimited as well. So go onto his website and you can type in the code. You'll get that if you are a patron to get 10% off your order, as well as Metal Fab Tokens. I actually do have a shipment of stuff coming in.
Do you?
Because he's got some wagers and overpowers in the same way as the Go Again and Dominate. Some assassin versions of that as well, I believe. And yeah, when that comes along, hopefully, fingers crossed, sometime next week. Don't hold me to it. But when it comes, I let the patrons know that there's some new stuff coming in and they can order it before I let the general public know. So good time to be a patron. Plus, you're supporting us and you get early access content as well.
Yeah, the main thing is supporting us.
I need to say thank you to Brandon, because apparently he sent Trip and I a care package all the way from Pro Tour LA via friend of the show, Rob Catton. So next time we see him, Trip...
incredible. Did Hamish not get any?
Metal Fab Tokens.
That's actually news to me.
Hamish just gets general shipments all the time.
You might have to send that on, because I don't think I'll be up your way for a bit. But that's great news.
Wouldn't that be Nationals? Wouldn't you pick it up at Nationals?
Yeah, Nationals, yeah.
Oh,
I might be able to grab it for you. If you went to Warsaw, you could have grabbed it then. Oh, well, anyway. Right, so home news. Home news. Let's make this quick.
Let's go for it.
Let's make this quick. Okay, I'm going to a wedding tomorrow. That's my home news.
That's your home news.
Too quick.
I don't really know what else actually happened. Oh, I'm organising.
You guys been playing Fab?
Yes, I did. But I'm organising going to France. My dad has brought a property in France.
And, oh, lovely.
He's got a Citroen H van, Google it, as well as a Citroen 2CV. Maybe Google it.
Nice.
I think everyone's heard of that.
2CVs are great upside down cars, right? They look like an upside down pram.
Oh, I think I know what you mean.
Okay, fair enough. So we're driving the H van and 2CV all the way down to France because he wants to get those cars down there. It's 7 hours once we get into France to his house. So and these cars go at a maximum speed of 50 miles per hour. So it's gonna be
that'll be fun. Yeah, 7 hours on the French roads in an old car that totally won't break down. You'll be fine.
Yeah,
great.
I will be obviously doing more about that as it comes along. But that's
love a European road trip.
I did one.
7 hours is quite a long.
I have driven to Spain. Not me. I sat in the car while my dad drove to Spain.
Okay.
2 days.
Where's that then? Is it Côte d'Azur? Is it the bit on the
Le Mans
bit on the west
area?
Southwest area?
Southwest.
I'm assuming it's by the sea. Yeah.
I don't know why. I don't know. Anyway, that's my home news. What about you, Simon?
So this weekend we took part in a lasagna bake off. There you go.
Against who? Now, the neighbours.
That came right out of nowhere.
A lasagna bake off.
Just the straight face.
It's the Nottingham lasagna bake off.
You live such a lovely life.
It was actually in Burton on Trent. But a friend of ours decided that he wanted to put on a bake off, and there were 11 teams. There were 11 lasagnas.
11 different lasagnas?
11. Yeah.
What did you have to do? What would you like? Lasagna?
The rules were it had to be homemade. All the sauces had to be homemade.
Right.
Get a Sainsbury's microwave.
Yeah. No,
that would have been me.
Well, no, because some people use like a jarred sauce, don't they? You're not allowed to do that. You had to make everything from scratch.
Did you make the pasta yourself?
No. So.
Yeah, there you go.
All right. Well.
But it had to be at least 3 layers. And it had to be like homemade. So
okay, Simon.
Mine had a bit of a variation.
I've got some questions. Simon. I'm sorry. I don't really care about the makeup of his particular lasagna. I'm more intrigued about this sort of competition itself. Are you all showing up with lasagna? And now is 11.
11. Yeah.
Servings.
It were meant to be 12, but someone couldn't make it.
Okay, in a tent.
No, in a house.
In a
so
house.
So you all showed up to savages. Someone's house with lasagna.
How are you cooking 11 lasagnas in one house?
They'd all been cooked. Like, we brought them and then heated them up in the oven.
Yeah, okay.
It's not bake. It's, yeah, okay.
But you don't eat your own.
Yeah.
I mean, you could do if you wanted to, but you mark everyone else's. Yeah. You try everyone.
But surely when you get to the last bit of lasagna, you're like, I'm fed up of lasagna.
You're right. You're absolutely right. We were third, and I feel like we delivered our lasagna to people third out of 11. So I thought that was quite a good place. We also did place third, so we got a trophy and everything.
Did the person who presented it first come first because everyone was really hungry?
They actually did. and then second
the
place
system's
was
flawed.
Like it was second place.
No, yeah. Second place was like 10th. So
must have been really
honest,
good.
I actually rate the 10th
really good.
The person who served it first, coming second, to me was the winner.
The thing is, by that point,
on our personal score sheet, the first person was actually the best, and it was the best technically across the board.
Oh my god! But the person who came second
did like a slow cooked beef like lasagna, so that was really quite nice.
Mm.
And then first and third, we both had like elements of chorizo and paprika and stuff in there just to spice it up a bit.
Well, Simon, I have to say that is the nerdiest, saddest, but yet most interesting thing I have heard in a while.
Were you drinking at all?
Yeah, there was beer.
Lasagna flavoured beer. It was Garfield weekend.
Who came last? What was the one that? What about the one that came last?
The one that came last, I think they tried to be a bit too experimental, and there were things like cinnamon in it, which didn't go down too well.
Cinnamon?
Yeah, I know. But yeah, no, it was actually a lot of fun. Everyone had a great time, but I don't want to see a lasagna for a little while now because I've eaten way too much lasagna.
Okay. Trip. What's your home news?
I can't be that.
I know. Well, I know. Just like that person that rocked up with the lasagna first and it was actually insane and was like, well, this is crap. What about you? Go on. What have you got?
Well, I was on holiday last week.
Where did you go?
I went to the New Forest, which was very nice.
Yeah.
It was great. It's Hampshire.
What
happened to the old forest?
South coast.
Well, it's full of wild horses.
It's
very nice. Had a good time. The biggest news though is I got the job that I applied for.
Yay!
So I didn't mention it. I realized I mentioned it on the podcast multiple times, so I thought I had to actually say I got it, otherwise would people just assume I didn't get it. Is that if I didn't get it, I wouldn't mention it.
Are you allowed to say what the job is?
It's just a job. I'm at the same place of
it's
work.
It's just a job.
I won't get into too much detail, but it's just a job.
Were you 007? Can you not?
No. You know.
MI6?
I work for the civil service in the foreign office. No, I don't. It's not true. But no, it's a job I applied for ages ago. So yeah, good news. But well, I won't talk for too long because it was meant to be a short home news. But then Simon entered a lasagna competition.
You guys,
so
I just wanted
not...
to say...
No,
I
no,
I, just
I,
throw
if,
it in
there's
there.
Any, if there's any reason to go off and do a long home news, it's entering a lasagna competition.
Yeah, I wasn't... That.
With 11 other... With 11
no, 10
contestants.
Other, 10 other. So we all tried 10 lasagna.
You have 11
teams of
friends.
Teams of two?
Teams of two, yeah. Well, so, yeah.
22 people involved in the creation of 11 lasagnas. My God. What a life.
Great Britain.
This is Britain.
This is Britain.
But what's wrong with it? Like, it was
there's
great
nothing.
Fun.
There's no, so the thing is, I think we are so... we do take the piss so much. Genuinely, we're both like think it's cool.
No,
that's going a bit too far.
No, wow. I did say it's the saddest.
I think it would be Trip. I think it would be your sort of thing. Hey, Mish,
I would get
so
involved.
All right, okay. When we meet up for this imaginary barbecue,
why did you say Hamish not so much?
I don't think Hamish would want to make a lasagna.
I can tell you right now that the idea of winning this competition is right up my street.
I would never
be part of making this. All I'll be doing is sitting there cheerleading Faye on as she's sitting there just, and I'd love it. She would serve you guys and she'd be like, it's rubbish.
You'd be the lasagna hype man, mate.
I'll show up in a Garfield outfit.
Also, I think your Faye impression was so high pitched it didn't come through on Discord.
No, no, no. But you'll hear it. You'll definitely hear it on YouTube. Me. Anyway, should we talk flesh and blood?
If you want a bit of a tease,
I don't.
If you want a bit of a tease,
I don't. Simon,
the next one we're doing, is in July, and it's a cheesecake bake off.
No, the thing is, I think there's 11.
There's
going to
be 16.
No, it's too much.
That's too much. Man.
It's too much. As long
16
as
16 cheesecakes. No, but at least with cheesecake, you can make a small cheesecake.
Yeah, you can make a small.
No, it's gonna be blind judge this one.
God, this sounds like it's soon gonna turn into swingers.
Let's start a lasagna.
Rate my wife. Rate my husband. The first one's always the winner.
Hamish has gone down a path I had to
throw this off course because I want to get into the flesh and blood.
Should we talk about the flesh and blood after 25 minutes?
Okay, so...
People have been saying they wanted longer... No, basically, whenever the non-flesh and blood segment is too short, they say they want more of that. When it's too long, they say they want less of that.
Sean just needs to chapterize it.
And Trip, you are right. This does taste a lot like coffee.
Mm. Yeah, it is, right?
Okay, so this has been the non-fab brew. Now to crack open the fab brew. So.
Oh, mixing up.
What are we going to do?
Well, I think we should talk about you guys.
We are going to talk a little bit about our ProQuest, Hamish. Because we went along to Angle Gaming Lounge. in Peterborough, and we took part in a 24-player ProQuest.
And
it was pretty stacked.
It was good. It was a good day.
Yeah. And what else?
And spoiler, we both top eighted.
We did. And what else?
We're also gonna do a little what's hot and what's not.
A little what's hot, what's not.
Okay.
Pre Warsaw, pre nationals. What's hot? What's not? Nationals is still a ways off, but pre Warsaw, what's hot? What's not?
Sure.
What's not to love about a what's hot? What's not?
We all love it. Right. So ProQuest thing, we will just sort of touch on it, right? Because what's hot, what's not always goes on because it's the best bit.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about that.
It does go on because we all have an opinion and Tripp's going to get cross.
Okay.
I always get mad. You just make me so mad.
I do.
With your opinion.
I don't. Mad. I know. I ask questions and you get mad. Right. ProQuest. Simon, you took Katsu.
Yes.
Why?
I did take Katsu.
That's all you own.
Yeah, well, no.
Do you actually have any other decks? You do. You had Chain. I mean,
I've got all the binders up until Dusk Till Dawn. I've got all the cards. I just don't build any. I put a Dash deck together for a couple of weeks. That was fun.
Yeah, I remember that.
While I was getting my Katsu cards graded, and now I've got them back, so I thought I'd go back to Katsu.
Yeah.
And I borrowed Pudding Tam's list from Pro Tour LA, and I just played that.
How was it?
I loved it. It was great.
Yeah.
You're just bonding people.
It was just very similar to my previous Katsu list. I think there was about 10 or 12 cards different. It didn't play Ancestral Harmony. It was just, I mean, if you've seen Pro Tour LA, it was very much surging lines in down to bonds, a single Magenshi, and just try and get a triple bonds turn and
you like linking people out. Linking people?
Yeah, I was linking people.
What's the point of the Magenshi?
In the longer games, it allows you to get some cards back.
Okay. Oh, right.
It didn't work for me.
It's not for the Lord of Winds. It's just to throw some cards back in the deck.
It is, but... That's how the recursion works.
Yeah.
Right.
Magenshi's into Lord of Wind, right?
Oh, so you do have a Lord of Wind in the deck?
Yeah, yeah. It's a block three blue cards.
You only really want one Magenshi, which is what I ran with three for a bit, which was a mistake.
Me too.
Because it's just such fun.
But yeah, I had a great time. I went 4-1 in Swiss, losing only to Hamish Chisholm Brown.
Hamish Dressing Gown.
Hamish
Dressing Gown. So I came third.
You lost to the gown.
And then in the top eight, I played against a local Nottingham player, actually, called Ollie, who won PAX most recently on the podcast. And he was playing Dorinthia Great Axe. And
good old Ollie.
That was horrible, horrible experience. For me, not for him. He won. I'd been out quite late the night before on a friend's stag do. And by the time we got to top eight, the tiredness has definitely caught up with me. Absolute state. I was never winning the game anyway, but it just compounded the fact that I was really tired and wanted to go.
Do you think Katsu can win it?
What? Win a ProQuest? Yes,
you're playing optimal? Yeah.
Not me personally playing it. I think Katsu in general can beat Dorinthia. You just have to line up a big triple bonds turn and get them down to a point where you can threaten their life total.
You have to get a lot of things right. Like, I think Katsu is pretty good, but you do have to... I think there's a kind of like a similar parallel from playing Bolton. It's like doing different things. But when you do get the certain things right, you're like, okay, I'm sorry. This is broke and there's nothing you
this
can do
about it. This is batshit crazy. Yeah.
But when it doesn't, it doesn't. You know, it really doesn't. And yeah.
I had some very, very good matches that day. Ours was a particular highlight, and it's on it was filmed for release by the local content creators.
Yeah, cardboard there. Is it cardboard swords?
Oh, cardboard is that board. Where cardboard swords
yeah,
are
yeah,
local?
Yeah.
Peterborough.
Nice. I also had a good game against one of the cardboard swords members. He was playing Dash and he had me pretty much dead to rights. It felt like he'd gone very strong in the first three turns. And then he absolutely bricked and had three items in his hand, and the game turned on a sixpence.
There you go.
It was a good day.
Yeah, it was.
Thanks to Angle Gaming Lounge, because it was a really nice, spacious venue. And if you went out early, they even had axe throwing there you could sign up for and go and have a go.
Yeah, they had axe throwing just there. So, oh, an axe throwing.
I didn't, how was your day, Hamish?
Yeah, no, it was good. So I picked up Bolton. I thought it, out of the two choices I've got, really, I could take KO, but not feeling it. Like, I think it's fine. And it's the target right now, right? So I'm like, I don't like to play heroes with a target.
Yeah.
And it's a bit of a weird meta, isn't it? Which we'll go through in what's hot, what's not. So I just took a Bolton. I thought it did me quite well for the RTN season. I feel like I've got enough outs against everyone. I know that my worst matchup would be Warriors, Dorinthia and Kasai. But I've got a combo plan, so, yeah. You know, I've got a plan.
You got a plan, which is good.
There were a lot of Warriors in the top eight, though, weren't there? There was you as Bolton. There were three Dorinthias.
Yeah.
Mm. No Kasai.
It was KO, KO, Leviah, Katsu, Bolton, and the rest of them were Dorinthia.
It was pretty crazy. But there was a lot of Dorinthias on the day.
Yeah. Okay, I did well. So
Hatchets and Great Axe, actually.
Yeah. So I took on... I went 4-1 in the Swiss. So you came third in the Swiss. I came second. And the Leviah player came first. I only lost...
And we all went out in top eight round.
Yes. I only lost to Tom. I think it was his name, Tom. I feel real bad.
You lost your second to last round, didn't you?
Yeah, so I lost to him in the Swiss, and then we did a rematch in the top eight, which was really cool, actually. It was
it was a crazy finish.
I scuffed the ending, but he was playing really well. I just had to... I made a choice when I was coming in with the Bottle of Courage for three. I had a Beacon of Victory in Arsenal. I had five cards in Seoul. I made a choice to only pump it by one, but the correct choice was to throw all five in. Because I had the Spirit of Arena, I could just drop the Luminous Sound to get action points back. Mm. So the Seoul that I was sitting around there was dead. And what I did is I killed myself because I went over. I couldn't...
You decked out.
I decked out, basically. And I just killed myself. If I just went over by one more, even if I calculated he had a fate for seam to throw on the board. But then it's one of those things where you sort of go, it's kind of doomed. And when I played him in the Swiss, I did a double Lumina and it wasn't enough.
You needed the triple.
Yeah.
And you got it off, but you decked yourself out because of it.
It is what it is. I actually had a really good time. He was a really good player. And I actually felt we were chatting after Discord and felt like I just met another person I would be happy to talk to and have a beer with outside of the game as well. So it was a lovely, lovely, lovely bloke. And I played Ollie as well with his Decimator Axe and and we got to just catch up. The whole day was just great. I was a little bit like, I will say, I did drive all the way home going, oh, could have won. Because I was actually for the first time aiming to win, which is not a good approach, I think, to go when you're going to a ProQuest. And it's the first time I ever went to a ProQuest.
Some would say that's the only approach.
No, I know. But you should really go to see your friends and play the game you like to enjoy playing with and just have fun, right? You know, that's usually where you walk away going, yay, that's good. But when you're aiming to win, it's really, really, really hard. And then you kick yourself when you feel like
you mess up.
When you mess up, basically. So I went home and I was a little bit like grumpus because I was like, darn, I could have. And I would have been up against Ollie again, and it would have been a KO final. And then you imagine, I could have. It didn't matter. But yeah, Bolton was good. I really enjoyed that. And I'd highly recommend going to Peterborough if you're going to a ProQuest.
Nice.
Cool.
Sounds like you guys had a good time.
We did.
Yeah, it was a really good day. It was nice to be amongst fellow flesh and blood players for a day.
I loved seeing James Armstrong pretend he enjoys playing the game rather than judging it.
he did not enjoy himself.
He picked up the hardest deck in the format, Prism, and went, it's not working. I was like, it's insane. It's close to Kano. In fact, he's probably harder than playing Kano.
It's a hard.
I think it is. Yeah, it actually is.
Yeah. Vincent is arguably
not old present.
Vincent's pretty bonkers.
I'd say Vincent is arguably harder, and it's only harder is because you're trying to do normal things.
It's just hard to play a normal game. Well, I've never played it, but I've played against Vincent, and it just feels like they put so much work into not losing.
Yeah,
like you're just like there's like so much effort to just like actually play the game.
Now,
it does really cool stuff, to be fair.
Owen, who we did a deck tech with Vincent, did say that like Kano players will look at him going like, "Bro, this is harder than playing Kano." But he says, "You could do some outrageous stuff, but you've got to think like wildly like turns ahead, and you're taking damage to even think of these turns ahead." Whereas Prism is not. It seems like it's insanely hard because you're actually doing a lot of broken things and you're trying to math out how, like, you kind of just get overwhelmed with how much mad shit is going on. Like, oh, you just draw two here and then you can play this and draw another three more cards. And it's like, what line am I taking here with all these cards? You know what I mean? Like, you're overwhelmed with cards. What is the right thing to do? And was even doing this the right thing to do? You know what I mean?
Was showing up the right thing to do?
Anyway.
I found OG Prism hard, but it was still so I remember playing it and just missing so much stuff. Like, I had Merciful up like a whole game and I was just never putting cards into Soul, and I still won because it was just so completely busted. I remember James was there and he was like, "You missed every single
every trigger
and you still won the game because it was so busted." And I was just like, "I'm having a great time, yes, we'll move on, yeah.
Should we do it?
The thing is though, we always say, right, do the intro.
Okay. It's been a little while. What's hot and what's not? There you go.
Got it straight.
That's pretty good.
I was going to say, we always say it takes too long, but there's a lot of heroes that are no longer in Flesh and Blood, or at least this not in true. What's Hot and What's Not anymore. So, I mean, who knows? Hopefully we'll get through a little bit quicker than we normally do.
Shall I do the running order?
Go on then.
Cool.
Lead off. Yeah.
All right, cool. We'll start off with a... What's up for Cass?
It's quite a spicy opening.
It is.
Welcome to Rafe is Spicy.
All right.
Spicy.
Very much so.
Sort of.
Katsu's
hot.
I think Katsu
I've changed
is
my
hot.
Mind back on. I'm not even pretending anymore.
I said Katsu was hot last time, and I still say Katsu was hot this time. He's not
triple,
the best
triple bonds is
hero.
Okay. Is this in the context of Warsaw, or is this in the context of ProQuest?
It's ProQuest. In the...
Could we say the context of Warsaw?
It's a good question. I think we should say Warsaw.
Yeah, I think that's better.
Because ProQuest is coming up to its end.
Okay, yeah. So Katsu in the context of a calling. Hot
still
or
hot.
Not?
Still hot.
Not
Katsu's
hot.
Katsu's a cool...
Not hot.
Katsu's
not hot,
hot
anymore, no. Okay.
No, I don't think Katsu is
on
a
fence,
calling...
Mate. I'm on the fence. Cool. If you are playing Katsu at the level
one,
of Pudding Tam,
no.
If you are playing Katsu at that level, you are going to make better decisions and you are going to win more than you're going to lose.
Sure.
I like Katsu. He's not the hottest hero, don't get me wrong.
No, he's not.
I think if you're going
as a meta breaker,
he's definitely off meta.
The problem.
Sure,
I'm going to be biased because I will say. Yes, and it was a good matchup. I will be biased because I will say Katsu's not hot, and then we'll swing round to Bolt, and I'll go, he's pretty hot, and I should be really, I should be disciplined. So
I think Katsu is not going to necessarily win the calling.
No,
but I don't think that
I
means
wouldn't be
that
surprised
he's not
to
hot.
See him top
I quite like Katsu in a he just always sneaks into top eights, and I think if you're fine with saying a hero is hot because they're going to get to a top eight. Which I think Katsu can do and probably will do.
What about
Hamish?
Victor?
I'm going to say Bolton and Katsu are on a similar level.
Yeah, I agree. So what would you say when you faced up against like something like Victor that's rising in popularity and Prism is rising up in popularity?
Oh, well, I don't care about Prism. So,
Prism's okay.
Victor's hard, but still, I like it. I'm not going to spend too much time on it.
No, okay.
Of course I'm biased. I'm very biased, but I said Katsu was hot last time, and I was rewarded for that. So I feel like I'm going to do it again, and I hopefully be rewarded again.
Okay, so mixed feelings. Dorinthia, hot. She is hot, right?
She's definitely hot. She's got
a lot of weapons.
Yeah, she does have a lot of weapons. She's well positioned in this meta, and well positioned to do well in Warsaw. So I would put that in the. She's in the hot. Yeah, Rhino.
She's really hot.
No, not hot.
Reinhardt calling is kind of space.
Putting
in the context of the calling is actually really interesting. Mm. I think I'm probably going to go with not hot.
I like
the idea of considering this in the context of an upcoming big tournament.
I could see
Reinhardt as a kind of sneak pick from some people, but I don't think it will play out personally.
Mm. I will go with the. I wish there was like a middle tier, but like, you know what I mean? Like
there's not. That's the beauty of what someone's not. We always say this, don't we?
Yeah, I wish there was a middle tier. He's definitely in a Reinhardt tier because every time he gets shown up, we always go, it's just Reinhardt. But I will say not hot. And Bravo. Man, what a fall from grace.
I know.
Not hot. And it's a shame.
For no reason.
He should be good. He's not...
I don't know.
He shouldn't be good.
Okay, here's a question.
He likes more... Like, the thing is, there's so many decks out there that are so good at shutting down these big disruptive attacks. And he's just... Mm. He doesn't... He was really good when, like... he wasn't really good at all, but he was good when there was disruption. He wanted to disrupt people and stop them doing their
Crippling
big turns,
Crush and
but...
Spinal Crush are cards.
So he was actually probably doing relatively well because the big heroes like Icelander, well, maybe Icelander was not a good shout, but like Lexi, they don't have like a lot of armor. So these Crippling Crush attacks are like, here you go. You know, you got to deal with it and you got to give me cards. Whereas nowadays, the meta heroes that are doing well, they've all got fridges. So these crush effects are really just like,
don't care.
No, they don't. They really don't care.
There is a bit of an armor creep in Fab at the moment that I think is worth bearing in mind. Like we saw this literally the other day with the new Ranger arms that's just been announced that has Battleworn as well. And it's just
Battleworn
like
a
lot of heroes are just getting little bits and pieces of like Battleworn or really efficient temper equipment. And there's with heavy hitters brought a lot of armor into the set.
The Brutes get the temper 2 arms and
Brute is a really good example of just suddenly they've got insane armor and they're getting the new
chest piece,
and it's just something that and the new headpiece. We've got like Crown of Prof and we've got the new balance
flesh bag and Brute is pretty
but something that people should be keeping an eye on just for some of these heroes is there's a lot of armor coming into the meta and it seems to be continuing as well. So it's just something to consider, and I think you're completely right, Hamish, for that reason. That
all right, not hot.
Moving over to Arcane Rising, Viscerai. Not hot, but
I've seen some people, some thumbnails, but I've
now
not Dramai's necessarily
gone.
Seen the game. So
there's thumbnails, there's tweets, but no
there's
results.
Tweets and thumbnails, but I don't see actual results. So I'm going to go not hot for this one.
I think
please DM us with your good results. We'd love to see them.
I will say that, like I said last time, he is positioned pretty well to tackle a side of the meta which is pretty slow. He's very good at dealing with that. He has lost one of his worst matchups, which is Dromai. But I just think it's just like you've got to put a lot of bad cards in your deck to do this. And when things don't line up, you really do get punished. And I am a Viz lover, but for Warsaw, I don't know.
I'd also just to add, like, I really would like to see the mixed arcane kind of return to the format in a more conventional way, which is what we were saying about armor. You know, armor is not very good against arcane, so like, and then, you know, having to cut armor to run AB, it's just not a thing that really you have to do anymore unless you're up against Viscerai. So I would like to see that come back. New Viscerai maybe would be ace.
Not hot. OG Dash, Inventor Extraordinaire. Trip. Come on, I'm just saying
not hot. No, I've said not hot every single what's hot, what's not since the dawn of time.
Why?
And I never really feel like I've been wrong. Like, there's been occasions where Dash has done really well, but I never really feel like Dash is the hot deck. It's just
And it's just damage, right? It is just an engine and damage and boost and damage and
it's
induction chambers and damage. And
the one thing Dash always has going for her is that she has a means to tackle almost anything, right?
Yeah.
But she's never the one that is leading the way. She's,
can respond.
Would you be surprised if you saw Dash win the calling?
I would be surprised.
You would be surprised. Okay. That's probably, and I agree, that's why she wouldn't be hot. But to see Dash win a couple of pro quests and tick along.
Yeah.
I'm like,
that's fine.
If I sit down and I'm playing a Dash, I'm always like, okay. I never feel worried.
No.
And I never feel like this is an easy win.
No.
But I never feel like it's a hard win. I just feel like it's a Dash. I know what to do against a Dash. And it just doesn't really impact me that much. I just feel like, okay. And whatever hero I'm playing, really, I'm just like, yep.
It is interesting because I do think you go, what sort of Dash am I seeing?
Yeah. You normally work that out in about a second.
Yeah, that
based
is true.
On what, when they turn the, they put the equipment in the field, or like you see a couple of attacks.
Like, yeah, okay, that's true.
I've got an idea now.
Maybe it's because the heroes I pick up don't change the strategy up for Dash. But anyway. That's Dash, not hot. Kano.
Hot?
Weird, eh?
I don't think he is.
Okay, in the context of Warsaw.
If I'm saying Katsu is hot, I've got to say Kano is hot.
You're stupid for saying Katsu is hot.
I've dug myself a little bit of a hole there.
Mm-hmm.
But I think I have to say hot. In that context,
he is basically a tier upon himself, isn't he? Like he's just uncomparable to really anything else. All he is just the I do my thing and I blow you up, and then I didn't blow you up. And
he's just not
like,
interactive, is he? So
no, like, he's a tear upon
you're
himself.
Be playing against Solitaire.
I have a slightly hot take about Kano, which is that if Kano was ever the best deck in format, he'd get banned.
Yes.
So he, by definition, will never. If Kano gets to the point where that's the best deck, I think LSS would just remove him from the game.
He's the jack in the box.
It would be a different kind of game at that point. It wouldn't be fab at that point.
No, but he's the gem jack in the box, isn't he? He's never. Mm. You'll see him. Dun, 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 dun. Oh, okay, you didn't win. Okay, cool. But, you know, when it does, I guess there was nothing I can do. That's just it.
Yeah.
Kano's just. He doesn't really know full well if he's going to win. But he.
I could see Kano. Yeah, I agree. I could see Kano doing well. I could see Kano making a top eight. And for that reason, I would go hot.
I will say hot, but Prism's a thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, but we'll move on. As we did.
Azalea.
Oh, yeah, she's hot.
Azalea's hot. Yeah.
She's hot.
She sort of sneaks around doing really well. And like, I always kind of forget about her. And then she wins a calling. And it's just like, she is really good.
So
the tools she got in Outsiders are incredible. Yeah. And just, good hero. Good, strong hero.
I despise
that
hero.
Saying that about?
Yeah, imagine, remember the days she was just shit.
I also think that she's not... I think they did really well with Azalea. I think they made her really good, really fun. But she's not... broken.
No, I think they've done the opposite. I think they've made Azalea they had an interesting potential thing about her, and I think Outsiders is just pretty much dulled.
She's not broken.
No. So they've dulled her to the like. It's not exactly anything of intricacy.
No, I still quite like what she does.
No, I don't. It's just.
I disagree.
She's
still
tall. She's
okay. We're allowed differences of opinion.
What? Who do you disagree with, Simon?
So, I disagree with you, Hamish. I don't think she's dull.
Oh, she is. She's so dull. Pump for free, fire arrow. It's like before, it used to be this nice little. Yeah, she wasn't very good.
Oh, she used to just lose.
No, no, no. But there was a way where you had to go. There was. I feel like there's just something.
Oh, she was great back when she was no threat at all.
No, there was like. Yeah. There's just. When Dromai got the tome, it really just went. Well, this is you kind of took away a lot of different ways you can do it, but now Azalea, there was like this real hard puzzle to work out, and like even like Viserai had that right. It was like, oh, okay, you know, things are powerful, but then you just gave us Revel in Runeblood, and it really goes. This is so good. Why would I not be forced to play in this certain way of playing? And that's what these pump effects have done, and I feel that they're just like there really isn't a better way to play
this. I think what you just said about Dromai is true. So I think there's a good idea under all that, but I don't think it applies to Azalea. But that's
anyway. That's, moving on. Anyway.
But she's hot, right?
Bolton.
Okay. If I say Katsu's not hot, I can't say Bolton is hot, but he is. No, he's not hot, but he's good, but not hot.
I'm going to say he's not hot, no, just to be as hypocritical as possible.
I'm going to say hot.
Why?
Because I think he can top eight.
No.
Don't think. No, weirdly,
Warsaw.
Yeah.
Bolton's a great day oneer.
Yeah.
I've seen Bolton do really well at a lot of day ones, and then day two he just disappears.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
The Kasai and Dorinthia being really popular is not a good thing.
This is true.
It's not a good thing.
We'll see. I mean, we'll see. I'm throwing it out there.
Yeah.
Okay. I just want to be controversial.
Yeah, okay.
Leviah.
I will admit, I don't really know enough about Leviah.
Okay.
Like, I see her do well, and then I see her do terribly.
That.
And I don't play her. And I really just don't know where to put.
Can I give you a bit of context?
Yeah. Context me.
Okay, so Leviah is actually got the most. She's probably the strongest brute. Right. She can actually be one of the strongest brutes in the game. Mm. The reason that she is not the strongest is because of the thing we've always known about Leviah is.
Yeah.
She kills herself.
Death.
So if she doesn't, yeah. But you always got to play the game of you could just kill yourself. And even
but
with all
with
these
the
new, No. Like even with the demi hero stuff, there is still a time where you go, I'm not gonna die, but I will deck myself now. It's just not you know, it's a different...
I think in the context of a calling. Bearing that context in mind,
mm-hmm.
I'm going to say not hot.
Okay.
Because I don't think you can lose to yourself and have the occasional game loss from just playing against the best players in the world
mm-hmm.
and get to the top eight.
Mm-hmm.
So I think for calling, I'm going to have to say not hot.
Yeah, I agree.
Not hot.
I agree. But if she got in now, would be like,
I'm not surprised
if she got to a top eight.
I'd be happy if she got to a top eight.
Yeah.
I think that'd be cool. All right,
who's up next?
That's it for Monarch. We're over to Tales of Aria, and now we are over to Uprising, and we've only got one left in that, and that's Fi, and that is a simple dog shit.
What happened to Fi, man?
Katsu's better.
I think, give him Belittle back. It wouldn't be the worst thing in the world. Just let him die.
Just
give him, just get him out of the meta. Just let him get LL.
If we
just
get
not Stubbies, but Belittle.
Can you imagine?
If we get Belittle back, Viserai would be really good. Like,
it's fine. I genuinely don't think it's. I didn't think it was a problem at the time. I think Fi was fine. Fi got hit so hard, and Fi wasn't even the best at the time.
If there was a Belittle, I don't know. That would be interesting, but no. In the context
there was a clear deck building restriction to that card that limited its effectiveness, and it's just like, come on, guys.
No.
Well, bring it back.
No.
But anyway, Fi's not.
Fi's not hot.
Uprising.
Dynasty.
Outsiders.
No, Dynasty. Arachne.
Not hot.
No. Okay, moving on. Outsiders.
Don't touch my cards.
No. Riptide. Outsiders. Riptide. Not hot.
Not hot.
No. We cannot even give
not,
this. Not we hot. Can. No. I know.
I'm not even thinking about it. No, I'm not even thinking about it. We can't spend 5 minutes on Riptide.
No.
I will say one thing.
No.
No. Just a quick. He's getting genuinely better.
Okay.
He is getting better, but he's not for the concept of for calling. No, he is. He is actually getting better.
Azuri.
I think I'm going to have to say not hot for Azuri, because I think I said hot last time and I don't think she really did anything. And I think it might be time to just say...
Well, Dromai's gone.
Yeah, Dromai's gone.
Dromai's gone. And Arachne can never be hot because of Azuri, right? Can we all agree?
Yes, okay. That's agreed.
So Azuri, is she hot?
I'm going to say not hot, but I'm...
How does she play into Warriors?
Happy to be
pretty. Kind of Arachne, right? Because whenever you she really does punish setup to like heroes really well, like, and we're in a bit of that meta, like slowish, want to try and set up big turns, and she's like, you never will, and it's just middling, and then she just comes back with, I'm also middling with everything as a non hit. It's like, you know what?
I think it's a risk. I would respect anybody that went with the hot, and let's see what happens.
We'll see. It'll be intriguing. Yeah, she's okay. One to watch, but right now I think not hot. Right. Who else? That was it. That's the only two new CC heroes.
Outsiders
moving over to Dusk Till Dawn. Okay.
Vincent,
not hot. Sorry.
Not hot.
Prism.
I am also going to say not hot.
Okay.
Not hot.
Hot.
I'm going to be the first one to say not hot.
No, she's hot.
If you're going to Warsaw,
she's not hot. If you're playing in your ProQuest and you know what you're doing.
That's a really interesting one. Because I would say the chances are higher of there being a cracked prison player out of calling than a ProQuest. A ProQuest, I think, is a no-brainer not hot. Honestly.
If you're the cracked player with the Prism deck that goes to ProQuest.
You draw two games and you go home sad if you go to the ProQuest.
I don't know.
You go to the calling, you get out of to the first two rounds, you got chance.
Right. I honestly, Prism in the context of calling Warsaw is hot.
I think your take is a good take. That's all I'm going to say, because I think I want to be wrong.
Mm.
I want to be wrong.
So you're going
to
say not hot.
Okay, cool.
Based on my feeling is not hot, but I would love to be wrong.
You're both hedging, she's hot.
No, I'm hedging.
If I'm saying
Kano
is hot,
I'm not.
I'm saying Prism is hot. Okay. Prism's hot.
Right, Prism's hot. She is hot.
Oh, so Simon just back. I'm sticking to my guns, guys.
I know.
If I'm wrong, I'm wrong. I'm not gonna.
No, I'm being consistent, because if I'm saying Kano's hot, I've got to say Prism's hot.
Kano is hot. Prism to me, not hot.
Okay.
And let's see what happens.
Bright lights. Dash.io. Weird.
Can we just do not hot, not hot, not hot? Just move on with my life.
Not hot.
Yeah, okay. Bye. Yeah, okay. Right. None of the heroes there are hot.
Let's get to jump forward to some more interesting heroes.
Okay, they are improving, but not there. Okay, we're now into the meta. Basically, we are into the meta, which is heavy hitters.
Should we start with Betsy?
Yeah, not hot.
not hot.
No.
Okay. Now it gets interesting.
The other guardian, Victor.
Victor. Not hot. I don't give a shit what anyone says. I know he's doing well. I know everyone's giving him the biggest beef.
I think I have to give Victor hot.
No.
Sure.
He's not hot. He's got six. He's got six good moves and then he's done.
Oh, it's the calling, isn't it? Because ProQuest Victor, I think, is very hot.
Yes.
That's the thing, right? Because he's good at just blocking everyone out.
He's not winning a calling. He's not. I'm with.
But what about the horse?
Well, maybe the horse.
don't throw us. Just completely throw us off. Off
well,
my
what about the horse? I thought that was Victor.
I'm gonna say not hot.
Yeah, he's not hot.
I'm gonna throw out a hop. Okay. I'm gonna throw out a top eight, Victor.
You are. I don't know what crack you're smoking.
I've got a pretty weird top eight of Katsu, Kano, a Victor.
Not prism.
Not prism.
Okay.
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 KO.
Yeah, he's hot. Obviously, he's
KO
best,
is
he's,
hot.
He's the best deck in the format.
Is he?
Yes.
KO is the.
Here's the best
deck in the format.
He's the easiest deck in the format.
No, so, okay, hear me out.
Yeah, sure. I would say that's fine.
Yeah. Now, is he... Yeah. Is he heads and toes above everyone else? No, he's not. No, he's not.
He's not heads and toes. He's only got one head, mate.
Right. He's only got one arm.
He's got ten toes. Yeah. And as far as we know.
And only five fingers. So... He is the best deck in the format. Like, he is. Is he counterable? Yes. Is he beatable by a majority of the heroes? Yeah, but if you could pick one hero that could largely just go into any matchup and go, I have a chance of winning. And I know and not every hero can go into every matchup and go, I can beat you. Like, you know what I mean? The worst matchup is... 40 is like a 60-40 to you. That's like, all right. You know what I mean? I think he genuinely is just the best deck.
I think that's fine. I think he's definitely beat, he's he? Definitely hot, and I think he's the deck to beat.
Yeah, he's gonna be.
He's gonna be the most popular deck.
You know what? Actually, weirdly enough, making a tangent here, if it wasn't for the fact that Dorinthia and Kasai are doing really well, I actually would have put my money that Bolton is actually the best deck. Like, straight up, the best deck in the format if it wasn't for Dorinthia and Kasai making it so miserable. It's unreal. Because he actually does have a game plan into everyone. And it's actually
all right,
not...
let's talk about Kasai then.
Okay, Kasai, she is hot.
She's also hot. Mm-hmm. I expect her to be in the top eight. Just one, though.
Yeah, I actually think she's the best warrior. And I'm...
Ooh, that's a... I do think Dorinthia's
no,
better.
No. Not anymore.
I do.
No.
I like Dory.
No,
I think she's hot.
Well. So, Kasai's hot, and she's the best warrior.
I like Dory.
Do you know why Dorinthia was good? The best shout for Pro Tours, because she's the best warrior to deal with Dorinthia.
Dromai,
sorry. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, she was the best one to deal with Dromai. But Dromai's not there anymore, so Kasai...
I quite like that take as well. That's quite interesting too.
Yeah, but...
I still... she's hot. What can I say? I won't say which one's better. I'll find out. We'll find out calling Warsaw.
Yeah, Kasai's close to being the second best deck, in my opinion.
And then last one?
Olympia.
All right, well,
Olympia is not hot, but I do want to say I really like the new Olympia card.
Yes.
Actually looks so like incredible. It looks so much fun.
It's so hero defining, isn't it? That's something that turns around and goes, I will do something no one else will do. And in fact, it's like a gameplay. It's a whole deck mind, like, you know what I mean? That's the best bit. Dorinthia and Kasai, that's why they feel like one of the same, and it feels sad that we're in that spot, right? Whereas Bolton is like, oh, I'm doing my own thing. And Olympia was kind of just like, what are you? You are so bland. But now...
Basically, you bring equipment from your sideboard by paying gold. I'm not going to read you the full card text, but really, really cool mechanic. Can't wait to see that being played, because that sounds like you can do some crazy fun stuff with it. So
But for the context of Warsaw, Olympia's not hot.
So I'm gonna say what my prediction for the top eight is.
Are we gonna do it for a top eight?
So it has to be based on what you've just said, right?
All
so
right.
Just bear that in mind.
You can only pick the hots.
Yeah. So what? Okay. One Katsu.
It's not getting into the top eight.
One Kano, one Victor, and then I'm going to say three KO,
Ooh.
And two warrior, if you allow that.
No, I will not allow two warrior.
One Dori, one Kasai.
Wow,
so
you're
3KO,
really...
Dori, Kasai, Katsu, Kano, Victor. But that's because I went so...
Mine's not far off, though. I was going to say 3KO.
Really? Mm. I wouldn't say 3KO.
A Dori, a Kasai, and a Bolton. Ooh. A Katsu, and a Kano.
All right. Okay.
What about you, Hamish?
I'd go with 2KO.
Yeah.
I'll go with two Kasai's.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I'll go with two Kasai's here. I undoubtedly feel like a Kano will just sneak his way in. I think it'd be ridiculous to not include a prism.
You have to. You were very hard on prism.
Yeah, you have to. I think you had to put a prism in there. I think Azalea will probably also rock up in there as well.
Notice Simon did put a prism in his top eight. Just saying.
Yeah.
Or Azalea.
Oh, I forgot about Azalea.
Yeah, Azalea. Azalea's a shout.
Actually,
Azalea's a shout. And
throw Katsu out.
To be fair,
Azalea Katsu. Azalea.
I'll drop a KO and put an Azalea in.
Yeah, and then my final call will be, for some strange reason, a Viscerai.
Sure, you can have a Viscerai. Tell you what, you're allowed a Viscerai.
I think for some strange reason. For the next couple of weeks,
you said he was not hot.
No, he's not. But I just think someone's going to come up with something.
If we make enough thumbnails saying that Viscerai is tier one, it just happens. That's how the world works.
That's how we go.
Yeah,
how we roll.
You never know.
You know what the thumbnail of the next this podcast is going to be? It's going to be Viscerai tier one.
To be honest, Viscerai, if Viscerai actually did reasonably well in the PTI or the ProQuest Plus. Which Battle Hardens are now called, the PTI event. And during Pro Tour Los Angeles as well, during the CC rounds, there was like Viscerai.
He had a bit of publicity, wasn't he?
He was actually keeping his
hold.
He does
numbers.
So a CC only calling? Bro, you never know. I think someone could probably figure something pretty consistent.
You never know. And we're gonna go back to these for the first time.
No, we won't. You'll forget.
We're gonna refer back post calling Warsaw, and we'll see how close you were.
Okay.
John, I'll make a note. Thank you.
We've actually kept that relatively brief for a what's hot, what's not.
Well done, guys.
That
was only 35 minutes.
Wow.
Well, thank you, everyone, for listening to this episode of Push Point. What do you think? What do you think is going to be in top eight? What do you think is a hot hero? Do you disagree? Do you think Prism is amazing? Do you think that Riptide is actually the greatest hero in the game of Flesh and Blood? Remember, hot. Not good, hot.
And don't
kick... It used to be if they were just hot. Now it's, they have to be good.
Yeah.
Please
don't kick me out of the Viscerai Club for saying Viscerai is not hot.
You said to be in the top eight, though, so...
That's true. You redeemed yourself.
Yeah. I think we should say... me and Simon are allowed to just throw Katsu into the top eight for free.
I mean, we're going to anyway. There's no stopping
us. Neither of you will.
Every time we do What's Hot, What's Not, we start with Welcome to Rave. I say Katsu's hot, and then I'm stuck for the rest of the What's Hot, What's Not. Like, oh, no, I have to say this here. Because it's clearly better.
Even though we all go, not that good. You're like, he's better than Katsu. Right.
But I was rewarded last time, so we'll see what happens.
Well done. Right. Thanks, Pudding Town.
No Jobai as well, so...
Yeah, who knows?
Right, thank you so much, everyone.
Thanks, everyone. Thank you for supporting the podcast. Thank you to all our new patrons. And yeah, again, if you want to join, details in the description if you want to support the podcast.
Much love. Love you, bye.
Much love. Love you, bye.
Bye.